on the scale of White House scandals, how does this strike you? A lot of people say, well, you know, there is no crime underneath this, or at least that does not appear to be like Watergate. How do you look at it?
Look, I don't think we know the answer to that yet. I think it's premature. You know, every second term president, certainly since Eisenhower, has gone into a ditch. The cardinal rule is when you go into a ditch, you stop digging. And so far, this White House has not stopped digging. You know, on the one hand, the president says it's outrageous. And then he goes to Baltimore on Friday and says, well, it's just a Washington distraction. This is serious business when you're talking about the IRS or perhaps changing talking points or the AP and wiretapping reporters, let alone Secretary Sebelius and HHS basically asking for money from industries that she is regulating. You know, people start saying it's a trifecta. It's really a superfecta, the top four. And the confluence of all of them erodes trust in government. It erodes trust in the president. At a time where the president needs to be working on immigration reform, on debt reduction, on the fiscal situation, on all the international issues, this has got to be a major distraction, and we don't know yet where things are going to lead. So the IRS matter is something that everybody in America can relate to. You know, everybody hates the IRS, and this just confirms the narrative. The White House, just to dismiss it as low-level employees, is not really what I think the American people expect.